Top 2. Good kill, good kill.
Hey, good kill.
Hey guys, welcome back to another video. We're here in the F-15X today, and we're going to be fighting the Sukhoi 35. Yes, that's the F-15X, not the F-15EX. I'll get into a little bit into the difference between those in a moment here. But let's go ahead and climb first. Once again, this is Musolo's F-15 modernized cockpit, along with his Sukhoi 35 modernized cockpit. We showed that off earlier. If you're interested in getting your hands on these when he releases them, the Sukhoi 35 one's already public, I believe. I'll have links to his Discord in the video description below. Now, from my understanding, the F-15X upgrade was an upgrade package proposed for the F-15 Charlie and Delta variants. Not to be confused with the F-15EX, which is a tandem seat of the F-15. You know, you got two guys in there, the pilot and the Wizzo, weapon system officer. But the F-15X is a single seat variant. Again, an upgrade package for the Charlie Delta variants of the F-15. We should have a Sukhoi 35 off the nose here, but I'm not finding him on radar. That is not a shortcoming of the F-15. Here we go, I got him. That's because I was looking in the wrong place. Here we go, at 26,000 feet I have him climbing through 27,000, just outside of 80 miles. Got him at 28,700 and climbing. So we'll continue to push him and try to get in range. Got him at 56 miles now, 39,000 feet. Bearing of a 100 off the nose here. He's locking me as well. Fox 3 from me. Not too concerned about that missile. He's always going to defeat it. All he has to do is simply reduce his altitude and he'll defeat that missile. Same with me. Or a missile that he probably fired. As you can hear, we have him in a single target track. Or sorry, he has us in a single target track. That's why I can hear his RWR. So I can basically assume a missile has been fired at me. I would assume that anyway, even if he had put me in a track while scanned and I wasn't hearing a lock tone, I would still make the assumption that a missile had been fired at me, because you're always going to assume worst case scenario. And we're cranking in order to drag his missile to one direction or the other. I have him at approximately the gimbal limit of my radar. And we're also diving in order to not only drag his missile to one side or the other, but also to drag it into denser air. All of these maneuvers will help to defeat the missile, meanwhile maintaining the lock so we can provide guidance to our own missile at the same time. That is one of the benefits of the crank. Recommitting here, and we're off again because his missile just went pitbull on me. I was recommitting there because I thought maybe we beat the missile, we can recommit quickly, but that was incorrect. The missile went pitbull on me, so we're gonna go off cold. For anybody unaware of what pitbull means that the missile has switched to its own radar during terminal guidance, no longer requiring guidance from the launch aircraft, so the missile is on its own at this point. So he is free to defend. Generally, with these more modern missiles, you can force them pitbull before they want to be, and they can probably still find the target with their own internal seeker radar, but the further the range you do that, the more the probability that the missile will go stupid, it won't see the target. We're going to recommit vertically here. So you really do want to get the missile as close as you can to the target before breaking that lock, even if you're going to do it early, to give the missile the best probability of finding the target with its own seeker. Defeated that missile, so we're gonna climb here and recommit vertically over the top here. You're never gonna see me try to defend a missile by going vertical. I'll only do that if I'm sure I've defeated the missile, because as you go vertical, got him locked here at 38,000 feet. As you go vertical, you become slow, and you're going into thinner air, which means you're actually adding range to the missile, but you are getting slower. So it's a nice way to get yourself killed. Again, I will only go vertical and recommit vertically if I'm certain that I've defeated that missile. Got this guy locked at about 33 miles, bearing of 100. We're just climbing through 24,000 feet now. We got him at 32,000 feet. I got shoot cues here. We're just above Mach 1, Fox 3, and we'll turn the other way. It's a nice little F-15X versus Sukhoi 35. It's like the modernized F-15 against a modernized flanker. Hopefully this fight never happens. Again, we never want to see this fight happen, because if this fight is happening, we're probably pretty close to somebody going nuclear. You know, we don't want that. We're off cold here. He probably shot at me, but again, I don't hear his missile currently. Right now, we're in the stage of the engagement where, you know, we're shooting from pretty far distances. 33 miles, not that high at 30,000 feet, but down low 30 miles is quite a long distance for a missile to want to travel. I don't hear his missile going pitbull, so I'm gonna, oh, there it is. They're always a little bit later than I expect them to be. We'll turn cold here just to be safe, drop some chaff there. And we'll defend here, holding on to my fuel tanks as long as possible. I hope he's having trouble with the AMRAAM I fired at him as well, as much as I am with his missile. Missile's still back there. The R-77-1 is a very good missile. The R-77M is even scarier with that dual stage booster, but we're not using that here today. It's just the R-77. I think we're good. I'm gonna recommit vertically. Just because I've been cold for so long, there's just no way that missile can track me, and you can hear the RWR went quiet, so I think we beat that missile. Sometimes when you recommit vertically like this too, it makes it more difficult for him to find you, because he's looking low for you instead of high. That missile is in front of me, but underneath. It's a little bit risky. Hopefully we're out climbing it right now. Got the bandit locked here. 33,000 feet, bearing 060. We're slightly below Mach 1 at 0.8 Mach, climbing through 20,000 feet. Bandit is at also 19,000 feet, so pretty much we're the same altitude here. As we climb, I'm pushing. I want to be above Mach 1 when I launch my missiles if possible. Got him at 27 miles now. Still pushing. He's right off the nose, and you know, we climbed over that missile. As you can hear, it's quiet now. There we go, Mach 1, 24 miles right here, Fox 3. We're gonna crank this way. So as you can see, we are slowly getting closer and closer to each other. The engagement initially started at about, well, we got him locked at like 80 miles, engaged at about 50, then 30, and now we're down into the 20s. And this will continue to devolve like this, down to 10 miles. That'll be the MAR, the minimum abort range, for pretty much on the deck. And we'll see who wins from there. We have 5 missiles remaining. Gonna put that missile on my 6. Let's go ahead and drop tanks here. A that'll give us a little bit more maneuverability. We've talked about this in the past, but dropping your fuel tanks is like taking your shirt off during a fight. You know, that's how you know things are getting serious. It's like, okay, we're getting, you know, closer to 10 miles, 15 miles. Fight's going to start to get spicy from here. Let's take off our shirt. Drop the tanks. Recommitting now vertically because I don't have those tanks. I'm absolutely blasting through here. We recommitted vertically at almost 30,000 feet. I doubt he's going to be expecting this. And I'm just slightly below Mach 1. Now let's see if we can find him on radar. Here he is. He's at 14,000 feet, so I've got double his altitude. This makes my missile much more dangerous. Fox 3. Although my missile is more dangerous than his right now, because I'm so high, I'm also much more vulnerable to his missile. So I have to immediately dive down and go cold, especially because he saw me. You know, we saw his radar locking me there. There it is. There's that missile. I'm going to dive down here, drag his missile into denser air. My missile's coming from 30,000 feet down, so it's going to be a bit of a challenge for him, I hope. Although his missile will also be a problem. We're going to flow cold here, and then let me just put him on my 3-9 line. Alright, this looks fine. I think we had a missile impact back there, yeah. So the fight is definitely getting a little bit spicier, as expected. The missiles are going to start landing all around us. That's fine, as long as it's not hitting us. He's still out there. And keep in mind, I've been firing some dangerous AMRAMs at him, and he's still alive, so gotta give him some credit here. 10 miles, Fox 3. And we're gonna defend. There's no need to guide at this range. You can just shoot the missile and just defend immediately. We're going super low because that missile is going to be very dangerous. He had the altitude advantage on me that time. He was at like 16,000 feet. Almost hit the ground here, but that should... Yeah, there it is. That missile drove that right into the ground. Super dangerous missile. Almost had me. Almost accidentally slammed myself into the ground just to survive that missile. Okay, we're gonna recommit here. Looks like he wants to step up the pace of this fight a little bit, and that's okay. We can certainly do that. I am in an F-15 after all. Here we go, got him locked. He's already recommitted on me. He's at 6,000 feet, just outside of 10 miles, it looks like. I'm gonna give him, here we go, 11 miles locked. I'm gonna give him 2 here, so... Fox 3 and Fox 3, and he shot at me. We're going to have to defend here and pull away. Good luck to him with those missiles. Place your bets, ladies and gentlemen. This is the final leg of the fight, I think. I think I have one missile left. Yeah, I have one AMRAM left. Look at how low we are. I'm honestly just hoping that his missiles hit the trees behind me. Missile's still back there. We're going to continue flowing cold here. I've seen a few people ask what going cold means. Going cold means to put the bandit like behind you, to fly away from him is to be cold to him, and to be hot is to have your nose at him. Just dragging the missile to the other direction now, because it was a pretty dangerous missile. Just want to be super safe. Okay, I think we're good. We're going to start recommitting here, because recommitment time matters at this distance. He's already got me locked, it seems like. Yeah, got him locked inside of 10 miles. 6 miles, Fox 3. Oh, this is bad. We're going to die. Okay, we're gonna have to do some real desperate stuff here. We're going super low, high G pull, below treetop level here, trying to drive that missile either into the ground or into a tree. Flying super low here at 6 miles. You can still hear I'm being tracked. Yep, missile's still back there. Oh, below treetop level, man. It's grass top level. By some miracle, I think we survived that. I can't believe that. It's a 6 mile R77 shot. I think just how fast I was, I think, is what saved me there. Missile's still tracking me, but I think we're safe. We're gonna recommit and hopefully he's dead. Otherwise, I gotta go gun him. I see a kill off in the distance there. Very nice. Looks like my AMRAAM found him finally. Took like 7 AMRAAMs before that one to get it.